Good afternoon. My name is Tyler Shumaker, software engineer at Concurrent Technologies Corporation. Going to give a little bit of a demonstration for developers on an open source product today called the S1000D Transformation Toolkit. The S1000D Transformation Toolkit was part of a bridge project, which was an OSD-funded project backed by the Advanced Distributed Learning Initiative. The project manager of Mr. Wayne Gafford, who's standing here with me. So HighLevel, the bridge project, the idea was to improve lifecycle management of technical training content. With the basis to do that, S1000D was chosen to be the specification to manage, configuration manage this content. The bridge project was broken down to five task. The first task was a ConOps, which gave the parameters and the operational scenarios for an S1000D development environment. The next task, which we were also involved in at CTC, was the Bridge API, which was a web services API that allows for the communication between the S1000D databases, the CSTBs, and the content authoring environments. This API had methods for connecting, disconnecting, your gets, your sets, your check-in, your check-out, your configuration management. So we've now standardized that communication with this API. One of the other tasks was also an aim and scope workbench implementation of S1000D specifications. So now in those authoring environments, S1000D data can be produced. Then this S1000D Transformation Toolkit, which we'll get into more details in a few minutes. And finally, there was a product data identification service. This service is based on the engineering chain proposals and helps identify where these changes happened inside of the S1000D data. There's also a cost-benefit analysis done as part of this task. There was a 10% reduction in total ownership cost because of the work that was completed. So where did the S1000D Transformation Toolkit come from? Why did we do it? Basically, it was a problem. There was not an interoperable publishing activity that supported building a multiple delivery platform from a lifecycle-aware learning content. So we identified this issue. We did not know who was going to be producing this activity, and I believe it was in February 2010 we decided we wanted to do a toolkit. It was Mr. Gafford's idea, and we sat down and we brainstormed about it, and we came up with the S1000D Transformation Toolkit as our solution, with the main aspects of this being it was an open source product that anybody could use. It was a separation of the source and the delivery formats. This would also bring in the management of the lifecycle and the configuration of the training content and the multiple outputs. We wanted to have this outputting the SCORM, we wanted that outputting the mobile, and also the PDF. This here shows just a brief diagram of the overview of the architecture that we decided to go with the toolkit. It's basically a black box, the toolkit is. It consumes the S1000D data. S1000D has the data modules, which are the smaller pieces that come in from the CSDBs, and also the SCPM that gives a structure in which these data DMs are designed. So as you can see, this is all housed in the database. Then you get into the toolkit is the SCPM and the DMs. Our toolkit's our black box. It transforms these into our output, which is a SCORM package in this case, in this diagram. It's mapped to the IMS manifest of the package. It's also mapped to the SCOs. And then this can be transported in any LMS. So here, this slide just shows some examples of our output. So our single source, our S1000D data, can be outputted, as you can see here, to many different outputs. We have two different versions of SCORM output. We have two different versions of the PDF output, and also two different versions of mobile output. We offer one version of the SCORM that has the assessments done with Flash, one version that's HTML. The mobile outputs, there's one that includes the assessments and that's a full course, and there's also one that's our performance support, which does not include the courses. For PDF, we offer a instructor version that gives the answers to the questions and a student version so that the instructor knows the answers to the questions within the PDF they print out, but the students can take the PDF, print it out. Again, this is one single source of S1000D based content that produces multiple outputs. So just go a little bit deeper now into the development side of some of the decisions we made in the toolkit. Like I mentioned before, it is open source. We have an open source site on SourceForge where you can find all the source code, all of our documentation, and everything related to the toolkit. There's a SVN subversion repository with all the code hosted out there that can access can be given to. The toolkit is a Java-based application. It's a Java jar that can be downloaded, dropped into any application. We also utilize Apache Ant for our build processes. We utilize the Apache Commons chain library, which gives us the ability to expand the toolkit. You can drop now in plugins. Things can be added to the toolkit easily because of this library. XSLTs are used for our transformation, CSS files. Our mobile output uses the jQuery mobile library. I believe at our 1.0 release, we went with the beta version jQuery mobile because that was the latest at the time. Since then, they have released the 1.0 version of the jQuery mobile framework. For the PDF output, we utilize an open source project called the Flying Saucer Project, which applies CSS style sheets to the XML to produce those PDF outputs. It's really slick and made it really simple to do that. One final thing for developers we include in our toolkit is the Eclipse files. So when you download our source, it can be dropped in an Eclipse environment and ready to go as a developer. So there's some high-level ideas of where we saw this toolkit fitting. First one would be in a S1000D CSDB. So this toolkit could be dropped into a CSDB that has all these S1000D SCPM files and DM files. And then that CSDB could choose to utilize the toolkit to produce their own SCORM packages, mobile output. The second idea we had was that the learning authoring tools, the LMSs, could implement the toolkit. Now they could now be working with S1000D, be producing in their authoring tools, you know, directly have that mapping that we have done. And the third is any independent application could implement the toolkit. Anything anybody can think of, they would have the need for this toolkit. It can now be used, like I said, it's a jar, can be dropped in, it has an interface, can be worked with, it's very simple. As I mentioned before, we took advantage of the Apache Commons chain library. This is a pretty fascinating library. It's built on the chain of responsibility design pattern. This allows us to do the plugins. If we want to add something new, it's not a strenuous process. We can write one single class. It's as simple as modifying an XML file. And now, as you see this process here that does a SCORM output, if we wanted to add a module into here or remove a module, it's as simple as writing that class, removing it from an XML file. And we could add multiple modules, we could add new branches, anything we wanted, and it's very simply configured because of this. One of the other key pieces of the toolkit was the viewer application, which is used to render the S1000D files without having to modify those files. Those files are now rendered at runtime in our SCORM packages that are output. This viewer application applies the XSLT style sheets, the CSSs, it applies the SCORM API communication that's used to do the SCORM calls at runtime. We handled assessments, as I mentioned before, in two ways. One way is with Flash templates, so that these will be done with Flash. They're a little bit more obvious Flash. They have more interaction. Then we also have a basic HTML interface that still can be do those assessments. So here's an example of another place we gave developers where they can modify the output. So you can see this is a SCORM output. It has a header image, has a bottom images. This shows right here the names of those files. You could simply create your new images, replace it into the toolkit. If you wanted to put a company logo up here instead of the default logo, just simply replacing this file, rebuild, and it's now in there. If you want to have more rounded back and next buttons, simply replacing these image files in the toolkit gives any organization the ability to create their custom output. A couple other things with our SCORM output that we gave the ability to modify was obviously our cascading style sheets, our CSSs. You can change the text, the font very easily with those. Our transformation files that transform those S1000D files at runtime can be modified if there's changes you want to tweak. The navigation from inside of the SCOs can be tweaked by simply modifying two JavaScript files here. So all this is detailed in our documentation for a developer so that, again, an organization can take the toolkit and produce any kind of different output. We also mentioned a mobile output, and this can also be modified. Again, we utilize the jQuery mobile framework, which is now a 1.0 release. Our version included the beta 3 release. But we also have some XSL files for the data modules and the SCPMs. These can be found. They can be modified if something wanted to be changed very easily. We have a performance support output, again, that does not include the assessments. This is your on the job. You need to know how to fix this now. It's your performance support. You have that with you. Then we also gave the full output, which includes the assessments. And they have also separate rendering for those. So this utilized some of the viewer application, and then it also had mobile-specific files that can be found in the source that can be modified. One thing we want to note here is if inside of the the S1000D environment, if there are flash files at source, we don't change those. Those still get brought in as ICN files in the S1000D project. So if you're deploying to mobile and it's on a device that doesn't support flash, you're not going to be able to see those, but that is the source, that is the S1000D data. We weren't going to touch that. Anything we create in the toolkit isn't flash in the mobile output. And last thing is our PDF output. As I mentioned again, we used the Flying Saucer project, an open source project that made it really easy for us. A couple CSS files, run through a process, transform and create the PDF outputs. We created one for instructor, one for the students. And this again it's very straightforward in the toolkit, but could be made a lot more detailed to meet an organization's needs. So that's everything I had for today. Thank you very much. Any questions?